Hello, today I want to give a demonstration of the program CGD Seal, a program to make astronomical images. CGD Seal is on the left side, and on the right side I've put in planetarium program Hello Northern Sky, and today I want to demonstrate how to image Messier objects within an area. I've drawn an area here as an example. This is the meridian. It goes from the horizon to Polaris. I will switch on altitude grid. So the dotted line is the meridian. Go back to RA deck grid, right ascension declination grid. And because the sky turns, this is about 2 hours before the meridian crossing. I can say I show how it moves. So if I change time, the sky is slowly moving. And from this line to this line, it's always 2 hours because it rotates around Polaris. So this distance is 2 hours and this distance is 2 hours. Okay, let's go back to system time. So the plan is to image all the objects in this area. So we'll image M44, M67, M48, and M46 and 47. I like to do it near the meridian because that is the highest position in the sky, and it will give the sharpest images. So CGD Seal, I have programmed a list of objects. It goes from M1 to M110. And I, for each image, I planned a 10 seconds exposure this time. It's a demonstration, so we can't wait too long. And I said, you can image it when it's 2 hours before the meridian crossing, till it crosses the meridian. Okay, let's just do it and see how it goes. So I start the sequence. It goes to the objects, you can see it here. And the first object it says which is possible is M44. So it initializes, and then within 5 seconds maybe it will start in an exposure of 10 seconds. There it goes. So the exposure is starting, you can see it here. I will make only one exposure in the demonstration, and then it will go to the next visible object within this window. Okay, the next one you can see as bold is M46. That's just above 20 degrees above the horizon. I didn't want to image too low, so again the lower limit is 20 degrees altitude. And any object which is 2 hours before the crossing, till the crossing itself. I don't want today have a meridian flip that slows down the process. Okay, M46 is finished. It goes to M47. It's the next object. It starts to plan for 10 seconds again. You can see it again here in the log. It starts the exposure. And then the next object will be M67, I expect. Yes, the next object is M48, not M67, that's the next one. After all objects have been imaged, it will go again through the cycle, so it will start again with M44. And pretty soon we will see M81, M82, because they are almost in the window, or the slice of the sky which I want to use for imaging. So M67 is now targeted. So again, this is my telescope, this yellow square. I forgot to tell you that. And it's, of course, it's controlled by CCDCL. Okay, M67 is finished. Okay, and it says, yeah, M82 is too not close enough to the meridian, so it goes again to the first target, M44. Okay, well, let it running. No, we cannot let it running. We have to. I want to show you how the sequence is constructed. So we have to stop the program, otherwise you cannot edit it. So we stop the sequence, and I open it. So again, this is the object, M100, in this line. So it goes from M1 to M110 or 109, I think. The plane is 10 seconds. And here the plan describes, so it's called 10 seconds, and also the exposure is 10 seconds, and it does only one exposure. The positions are in these two columns, and here specified that I want to start imaging 2 hours before the marine crossing, and stops or let's say. It will not be selected when it's past the marine crossing. I've specified here don't wait, so if it's not within this slice of the sky, it will go to the next object. And also can specify the repeat. Here's one, but I also can make it 5. And when I have enough exposures of an object, I can just change this 1 to 0, and that the object will be skipped any time. The whole list is repeated, so it goes to it will image a few objects which are in the slice, and then the list is repeated. And if I type here 99, it will keep on repeating the loop for the whole night. Well, we can save it, doesn't matter. And in the preferences, I have specified for my observatory that I don't want to image below an elevation of 20 degrees. Okay. So back to the sequence. Let's start it again. Let's first have a look when M82 is imaged, or M81. It will be in 20 minutes within the slice. So what I will do now is I will change the time to speed up a little bit. That's possible in a simulation. So I'll go a little bit in the ahead with time. So let's say 2050. Well, let's make it 59, doesn't matter so much. Change. Okay. I'll also force an update quickly. So the time is now 20:59, and you can see that M81 and M82 are now within the slice. And let's start the sequence again. Let's see how it goes. So here you can see it goes to the objects, and most objects are not within the slice. And of course, it starts again with M44. So let's just the sequence run, and then one of the last step in the cycle will be imaging of M81, M82. And you can see M48 is now outside the slice. So that is not imaged, that's correct. And I think after M67 it will start imaging M81, M82. Okay, M67 is finished. There it goes. It goes to M182, as also indicated here in the list of the sequence. And after this object, it will go back to the first one, M44. The planetarium program Hello Northern Sky is linked to CCDCL and also to Telescope. So CCDCL is controlling the telescope and the position is read by the planetarium program and displayed in this map. So you can see it goes back to M44 and the cycles will keep on going, and then in maybe 1 hour these two objects, M105 and things M95, will be imaged, and these two M97 and 98. So this is a very useful tool to image objects when they are in the highest position of the sky, and of course with most likely the best seeing. Let's have a quick look again to the sequence. I want to demonstrate how you can add objects. I stop it, otherwise you cannot edit it. So this is a list I made of all Messier objects, and well, you can add an object. So let's add a new object. We have now an internal database where you can search for objects. Let's take an exotic one, SHA+2105, and it fills in the most common names. So Crescent Nebula, and an NCG number and the position, and you can keep on adding objects. That goes quick. So I put a mouse here, I select an object, like we could try Dark Nebula. I think this one is available, I'm not sure, but let's try. Yep, P1010 with the position. Okay, that's it. Thank you for your attention.